Hi, everybody. Welcome to Queens Library's Grab and Go Planes and Trains Activity Kit program. My name is Miss Sandra, and I'm one of the children's librarians at the Broadway Library. So before we start, I just have a few announcements, and then we're going to get into a really fun program today. So we just wanted to let everybody know that all Queens Public Library locations are open right now. You can enjoy unlimited browsing and seating at our libraries. There are no time limits, but masks are required for everybody in the library. And to learn more about any of these things, see our virtual program calendar, access digital services 24/7, or get an e-card, you can visit www.queenslibrary.org. Again, that's www.queenslibrary.org. So we are currently doing our programs for summer reading. Reading Takes You Everywhere, and that continues this month. And all year long, Queens Public Library marks its 125th anniversary. And again, visit queenslibrary.org for book lists, resources, and more. Also, we want everybody to know that the next election takes place in November, and visit voting.nyc to learn what's on the ballot and to stay informed. Okay, I think we are done with our announcements, and we are going to get into some really fun programs now, some really fun stories and songs, and I'm going to demonstrate for everybody our kits. So the kit that I'm demonstrating today is called Let's Go Planes and Trains Activity Kit. And on our summer reading guidebook, which you can get in the library, it is on page 12 and 13. So if you go to page 12 and 13, there are instructions on how to do this, how to do all the really fun activities in this kit. And this is a great guidebook. You can pick it up for free at the library. It has a lot of activities. It has book lists. It explains the summer reading program. And on page 12 and 13, there are instructions. Please note there are small little stickers in this. It is aimed at ages 3 to 5. There are small little stickers, so there is a choking hazard warning on it. I know, like, I have young kids at home, so if you do have, like, young kids in your house, make sure that, you know, the little stickers and the small pieces are away from them. All right, so let's get into it. This is kind of what it comes out to. We're going to be making these really fun little travel kits. You can actually write me in the comments if you're going anywhere this summer, if you're taking a plane or a train, if you've ever been on a plane or a train, where you went, let me know. Also, the fun thing about it is when we read books, we can learn about all the fun places that we can go. So I'm going to just walk you through everything in the kit. You get a glider. So you can make your own little airplane, which is so fun. This is how it comes out. They actually fly. If you attempt to fly them in the air, they do fly. And these are pretty simple. So you actually are just, it's basically two pieces. You're just going to put this part through here. And and that's your airplane. They're really fun. You also get, and this is where it gets exciting, because you get to pack your little suitcase. So you get one of these really cute little boxes, and you might need a little help from mom or dad putting these together, but you put the bottom part together. So you kind of like put that together, and then there's this little thing on the side. You take that out, and then you just stick this through like that. You're going to stick that through, and then you're going to do the other side. So I'm going to take that part out, and I'm going to do the other side like that. And that's my box. But before I close the box, I'm actually going to put all of my fun things in the box. So you're going to get two sheets of paper, and these are all the things that we like to take on our trips. So you have all of your fun little things you're going to pack in your suitcase, and you can cut these out with scissors. If you're a child doing this, you are a child doing this, make sure to use safety scissors just to be safe. You can cut these out. You can color them with markers. So you're packing your suitcase, your toothbrush, all the things you would take. And we are going to pretend we're going on a plane. So you have your passport, your boarding pass, your luggage tag, all of your ID, all your travel documents you would need to go on a plane. So you're going to cut all these out and put them in your suitcase. So I did that with mine. I have my shirt, have my pants, my socks. I have my boarding pass to get on my airplane. I have my hat. Have my passport, and I have my book. That's really important. There's a book on there. Have my shoes. I have my toothbrush, and I also have my ID. That's really important for getting on an airplane. And then I have my fun little stickers that I can decorate my box with. So these little fun stickers come in your kit. So these are really exciting. So that is our packing our suitcase portion of our kit. And lastly, you're also going to get this wooden little train. I actually love these. I've used these a lot in my programs in the past. So some fun things you could do with your train are you can color them with markers. You can use crayons, but markers work better. You can also paint these at home. They come out really nice with paint. If you have paint at home, and if you have a little magnet at home or even like a piece of tape, you can put these on your fridge or something, you know, like you can use them for pretend play at home. But if you have a magnet, they become really great magnets at home too. So that is it. That's how we make our planes and trains activity kit. Again, I'll show you this little box. I put my luggage tag on it because this is my luggage. And you can write your name and your phone number on it to make sure it's not lost. You have your little glider that you can make. You have your train, and you also have all of the things you're going to. Okay, you have all the things you're going to take with you on vacation that you need to pack your bag. So that is super exciting. Okay, and I think are going to sing a song about trains now. So let's all just give a big choo-choo. Okay, and we're going to sing Down by the Station. It's a really, really fun train song. Okay, so is everybody ready? Ready, one? Because we want to get excited about our kits that we're making and also for traveling anywhere this summer or, you know, anything we read about in our books. Places we want to go. So ready, one, two, three, ready. Down by the station early in the morning, see the puffer bellies all in a row. See the station master turn the little handle. Chug, chug, toot, toot, away we go. Yay, give yourselves a round of applause. That's great. Again, write me in the comments, you know, if you took a train today. I know we take trains a lot in New York City. So anywhere you took a train recently, that is really fun. Or your favorite type of train, you can let me know. And we are going to read this really exciting book about trains. It is called Terrific Trains. It is part of our nonfiction collection. So that means the information in this book are all facts. They're all true. Things that we're going to learn today. And this book is located in the 625 section of the nonfiction section. So 625 is the Dewey Decimal number. So anyone going into the library that wants to learn more about trains, you can look in 625. And this book is by Tony Mitten and Ant Parker. And we'd like to thank Kingfisher Publishers for giving us permission to read this story, this book. Okay, we are going to read Terrific Trains. Big trains, small trains, old trains and new, rattling and whistling, choo, choo, choo. Let's all say choo, choo, choo at home. Starting from the station with a whistle and a hiss, steam trains huffing and puffing like this. Diesel trains rushing as they rattle down the line, warning us they're coming with a long, low whine. Metal wheels whirl as they whiz along the track. They shimmer and they swish with a slick click clack. Let's all say click clack, click clack. Coaches are coupled in a neat low chain. An engine pulls the coaches, and that makes a train. That makes a train. The engine makes the train. Good. If a train meets a river or a valley or a ridge, the coaches rumble over on a big stone bridge. Can everybody see the bridge? Good. If a train meets a mountain, it doesn't have to stop. It travels through a tunnel, and your ears go pop. Let's all go pop. When too many trains try to share the same track, the signals and the switches have to hold some back. Sometimes they have to wait when there are too many trains trying to get through. When the rail meets a road, there's a crossing with a gate. The train rushes through while the traffic has to wait. Trains travel anytime, even very late. The train's delivering a big load of freight. This train is for passengers. It's ready at the station. All aboard and wave goodbye. Let's wave goodbye. We are going on vacation. Let's all wish them a good vacation. They're going on vacation. And this book is really cool. It shows you all the train parts at the end. That is great. Great job, everybody. We're all going to say the end and give a big round of applause. Good job. Nice job, everybody. Okay, so now that we've learned about trains, we are going to learn about planes. Is everybody ready? Okay, we are going to learn about planes. Okay, so we are going to start learning about planes with the Airplane Song by Lori Berkner Band, and that's such a fun song. So let's all just go like this, like we're going on an airplane. Let's pretend we're flying. Good. Okay, and if you're doing the song at home, you can literally put anywhere you want to go in the song. I'm using a few different states today or in places, but anywhere you want, you can put in the song. So ready, everybody? One, two, three, ready? We're going on an airplane and off we go. Going to the park is first, you know. Now slow it down and land on the ground. And when you get out, we're gonna jump all around. Let's all go jump, 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 jump. Good, let's all go jump, jump, jump. Okay, now it's our next stop on our airplane, ready? We're going on an airplane and off we go. Going to California is next, you know. Now slow it down and land on the ground. And when you get out, you're going to spin all around. Good, give me a big spin at home, good job. Okay, get back in your airplanes and off we go. Going to Maine is next, you know. Now slow it down and land on the ground. And when you get up, you're going to gallop all around. Okay, make sure you're galloping at home. Good job. Okay, and we have two more stops on our airplane. Ready? Get back in your airplanes and off we go. Going to Arizona is next, you know. Now slow it down and land on the ground. And when you get out, we're going to dance all around. Good, let's all go dancing at home. Good job. Okay, we have one more stop. We're going on our airplanes and off we go. It's time to go home. Your family and friends are waiting, you know. Now slow it down and land on the ground and come sit down in your hometown. Good. So now we're back home. Great job singing with me, everybody. Thank you so much. And we have one more book left. And this is called Planes, and it is by Amy Shields. It is in our 629 section of our nonfiction. So 629.13 is the Dewey Decimal number. So that's where you would go to look for books about planes. And we want to thank National Geographic Publishers, which are an imprint of Penguin, for allowing us to read this today. So thank you so much. And we are going to actually follow Pilot Nick around. She's going to show us all the different planes. So let's all wave hi to Nick. Say hi, Nick. Good job. And she is showing you right now the cockpit of an airplane. So, and the title of this page is Flying High. There are seat belts, but no steering wheel. There is no gas pedal. Where are we? We are in the cockpit of an airplane. Hi, I am Pilot Nick. Welcome aboard. So now she's showing you where you would sit on an airplane. This is what it looks like. And the pilot sits in the cockpit and we sit in the cabin. It's called the cabin where we sit. It's just like home, but 30,000 feet in the air. We're really high when we're on an airplane. And this is what the neighborhood looks like when we take off and we're starting to see the land before we get up in the clouds. And she's saying, I can see my neighborhood. Look out the window from above. The earth looks like a quilt of fields, forests, cities, and towns. Okay, this is a really cool plane. It's called a sky truck. So some planes do not have TV or snacks. They are working planes. This is the inside of a C-17 Globemaster. It carries a mobile home bolted to the floor. So that is really cool. Some planes are built to carry stuff, big stuff. This is the Antonov 225. It is the biggest plane ever made. Wow, that's awesome. Okay, the smallest plane used to be the Bumblebee. Can everyone see the Bumblebee plane? It is 9.5 feet long. Then came the Bumblebee 2. It was about a foot shorter. So Nick is also showing us that there are also remote control airplanes. You can write me in the comments if you have a remote control airplane at home. They're really fun. She's also going to show us the fastest plane. The fastest plane is the SR-71 Blackbird. Only two people fit in this plane, and it flies 3,418 miles per hour. Wow. Okay. Let's see what other planes she's going to show us. Okay. Long ago, some pilots painted their planes with scary faces. Can everyone see that? These planes are called Flying Tigers, and they were flown in World War II. So a long time ago. Okay. And this is a city on the sea, which is really cool. She says, I am in there. You can't see me. Most planes leave the ground from a runway, but sometimes the runway is in the middle of the ocean. The USS Enterprise is an aircraft carrier. It carries 70 airplanes, 5,000 people, and enough cooks to make 15,000 meals per day. What? That is so cool. Okay. There's also something called a flying gas station. Like when we go to the gas station and we fill up our cars, there's a flying gas station. Here is another pilot with nerves of steel. This little plane is a B-2 stealth bomber. The pilot is filling his gas tank while he is flying in the air. Look how cool that is. That's the gas tank, and it's giving the plane gas in the middle of the air. That is awesome. Okay. These were the first people to fly a plane. The Wright brothers were brave too. They were the first to fly a plane. That was more than 100 years ago, but we still remember them. They were smart and unafraid, and they did it first. Hooray! Let's all say hooray! Okay, 100 years before the Wright brothers, somebody else was dreaming of flying, but this balloon was never built, so no one ever flew it. But look at that really cool balloon that they drew because they wanted to fly. That was in 1803. Okay, so that is it. We're going to say the end, and let's all give ourselves a round of applause. Great job listening. Thank you so much, everybody. Again, this is what the kit looks like. This is the glider. And here is the train, so you can pick that up at your local library. And we're going to sing our goodbye song now. So ready, everybody? Goodbye, everybody. See you soon. See you soon. See you soon. Goodbye, everybody. See you soon. We'll see you all next time. Yay! Good job, everybody. Thank you so much for watching today. I'll see you next time. Thank you. Bye, everyone.